When I first got started on YouTube, I was trying to figure out every possible way to make my profile, my channel, look more professional than it actually was because I was clearly a beginner YouTuber. I didn't know anything that I was doing, so I was just trying to figure out how could I make my channel look a bit more professional so that people really believed me, clicked on my channels, watched my videos, and just thought that I was serious about this whole entire thing. So I would see other YouTubers that had the subscribe button down in the bottom right hand side of their video. I saw that YouTubers created like custom thumbnails and they had those like info pop-up boxes here, and then they had end screens, and then when you went to their channel they had a nice banner and they had different sections, and I just tried to figure out how I can make my channel look a bit more professional. So today I just want to help you with some things that can make your YouTube channel look a bit more professional so that people actually take you seriously on this platform. Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I'm Cathrin, the creator of The Content Bug, and I'm here to help you follow your passion by growing your audience online. And today, you already know that we're going to talk all about YouTube, so let's get to the tips. I have to tell you from the very beginning, some of these things are not available until you hit your first 100 subscribers, your first 1,000 subscribers, until you get a certain amount of views. All these things go based on how experienced you are on YouTube. They block off certain features that are available. So let's say that you actually want to monetize your YouTube account, you want to make sure that you put ads on all of your videos. You actually can't do that until you hit 1,000 subscribers, and then there's a certain amount of views that you actually have to have on your YouTube channel before you can monetize your YouTube channel. And there are some other things that have that limit too, such as a custom URL. So if you want to create a custom URL for your YouTube channel, I think you have to have 100 subscribers for that. And then I think to add the subscriber button, you know, the subscriber button that appears right down here, I think you have to have 100 subscribers for that, but I'm not 100% sure. So there are some easy things that you can honestly do to make your YouTube channel look more professional. And let's start with the videos. So when you are shooting your videos, you want to make sure that you have consistent lighting. So you want to be shooting near a window, make sure that it is a cloudy day, completely overcast, not too sunny with like few clouds in the sky. You want to make sure that the lighting is consistent. You don't want the sun coming in and out between the clouds. Or if you actually have lighting equipment, I have lighting equipment here, you want to make sure that you have lighting equipment on, the blinds are closed so that the lighting stays consistent. You also want to make sure that you have a good camera and that you are in focus. If you are new to YouTube and you're using your phone, that's fine. You can tell if you are in focus. If you are using a camera like me, it is hard to tell if you are in focus because I do not have a screen that is facing me. It's just kind of trusting my luck and seeing what I get here. So for the most part, I like to think I'm in focus, but I know sometimes it doesn't always happen. You also want to make sure that your editing quality is strong. So whenever you are editing your videos, you want to make sure that you're doing a good job with that. You're abiding by the standards within YouTube. You're cropping out what you're supposed to be cropping out, and you're doing minor changes to make your videos look better. I do actually have a YouTube video on how you can make your YouTube videos look better through your editing. So if you want to check that out, it's included in the description bar down below. And then the last thing that you can really do when it comes to editing your YouTube videos before you even upload them to YouTube is to consider doing an opening screen or a closing screen. So I actually have a closing screen on the end of all my YouTube videos. It's just a black screen for 5 seconds, and then I add 4 relevant YouTube videos that I think the person would like to watch if they make it to the end. Then I give them recommendations to continue watching and to keep learning more. So that is something you can consider when you are getting started with your YouTube channel, as well as, I guess you can say, if you want to be more professional, come up with a general thing that you say every single time. So mine is, "Hey guys, what is up and welcome back to my channel," and then I go into who I am and what I do. So if you want to come up with your own little catchphrase that you include every time, you can go ahead and do that as well. Then when you upload your video, there are a few things that you want to do. You can add info cards. So like I was talking about popping up right here, those are info cards. You can easily add them when you are editing your video before you upload. Make sure you add them when they are relevant, or honestly, you can add them every 2 to 4 minutes so that it keeps the audience engaged. And if they really do want to learn more about something, or if maybe you have another catchy video that you think that they would like, they may end up clicking on that, watching another video, and it's just going to get more views for you, which is good in the long run. And then you also want to use an end screen like I was talking about. I have that black screen for 5 seconds. You can add a template where you can have either videos that you want to recommend to people, or you can have a little subscribe button there. That is a great way to end your video so that you get more people to subscribe, and it just kind of makes you look a little bit more professional because you know what you're actually doing on YouTube. Now let's talk about your actual channel. So when you go to your YouTube channel, it's basically like your YouTube page, like a Facebook page, I'm referring to it as. But your YouTube channel, there are a few things that you can do to make your account look professional. And the first one is to design a custom banner. It's not that hard. Use Canva. It's completely free. Design a custom banner. Upload the image. See if it works. If it doesn't, make some tweaks. Upload a new image. Just mess around with it until you get a banner that you like. Then you want to develop your about section. Within your about section, you can include links to your website, to your Instagram, to your Pinterest, to your Twitter, to your Facebook. You can include links just about anywhere. So if you want to include links, that is a great way to look like you know what you're doing, because you are leading people from your YouTube channel to your Instagram account or whatever social media platform you are recommending. Every YouTube channel comes custom with a design of the channel page, meaning the sections that are included below. If you ever see a YouTube channel that has different sections below where it looks like they customize, some videos are going horizontal, there's some that goes six this way. It all just depends on kind of the settings that you set. You can completely customize your YouTube channel and select what you want included down below. So you can select your most recent uploads, you can select your most popular videos, you can select some of your playlists. It's really just up to you what you want to include down below. But the more you customize that, the better, because it's going to really help people to understand, one, what's on your platform and what videos they can already watch that are available. And it just makes you look like you know what you're doing and that you're really interested in helping them find the content that they are looking for. And then you've probably heard of a trailer video before. You can have a trailer video on your YouTube channel. So for anyone that's not subscribed that lands on your YouTube channel, you can have a video that automatically plays that pops right up, the first one that appears, and you can set that. What I recommend doing is either creating a custom trailer video for your YouTube channel, or take one of your most successful videos or a video that you think people will find really interesting, one of your best edited videos even, and include that as your trailer, because that's going to be a great way to capture some people that aren't subscribe to your channel with hopes on transforming them into long-term subscribers. Then once you hit those certain subscriber marks that you have to hit, there are a few things that you can do. You can add that little subscribe button that is included down here. You just upload whatever image you want and it will appear in the bottom right-hand corner of your video. You can decide when it appears, if it's going to be there for the whole entire video, if it's going to appear after 5 seconds, 10 seconds, whatever you want. You can also apply for monetization, even though that's not going to happen until after 1,000 subscribers. And of course, you can create a custom URL once that is available to you after 100 subscribers. So there are a few things that you can do to make your YouTube channel look more professional. It really comes down to the way you edit your videos, the way you upload your videos, and the look of your YouTube channel. And then once you hit those certain subscriber marks, then more options are available to you. So that is it on how to make your YouTube channel look a bit more professional. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And I will see you guys back here on YouTube or on thecontentbug.com very soon. Bye guys. And I forgot to tell you guys, design custom thumbnails. Designing custom thumbnails is extremely easy. Do it on Canva, add a little text overlay, and it's going to make a big difference within your YouTube channel to make it look like you really know what you're doing. So add custom thumbnails, so easy to do. Now I'm really out of here.